Hi there, my lovelies. So today I'm going to be making some simple chocolate chip and orange cookies for you today. This is a very simple recipe, and if you'd like to follow along at home, I will leave a list of ingredients and measurements in the description box below for you. So over here I have some essences. I have my orange, vanilla, and my lonely little egg here. So first, in this bowl here, I have my sugar, my butter, which I mixed together, and my chocolate chip cookie. So it already looks pretty doughy, but we still have to add our flour and our essences and our egg. So what I'm going to do is slowly add in my flour in a moment. But first, we're going to put our essences in. So I have this very concentrated orange essence. You only need about a cap. And a half of it. As I said, it's very concentrated, so it's quite strong. Next, we'll be adding some vanilla, and I only used around half a cap for this. It was just to balance out the sweet and the tartness of the orange essence. Okay, so again, you want to mix these in very well to make sure your cookies have maximum taste in every part. Now I'm going to add my flour. So I'm using plain white flour, and there is 225 grams in here, and I'm going to add it little by little so that I can make sure it is mixed in thoroughly. It's a lot easier to mix your dough if you put it in a little or piece by piece rather than the whole lot in one go. That's just what I found, it's just a personal preference. So mix in my first lot, and as we go I'll just add it in slowly. Now I don't know about you out there, but I find baking very therapeutic. I am a very tactile person, so I like to mix and play with dough. I think it just reminds me of my childhood, when I used to bake a lot with my mother. She taught me a lot about baking, and I think I've picked up quite a few recipes from her, but I'm always on the lookout for making something new. So if you guys would like to see me make something, maybe a cake or some fudge, anything you like, I will try my best to make a baking video for it. So let me know what you guys think. What's your favourite sweet treats to make? Or just to eat? Okay. So the mixture might look a little bit dry, and it looks very crumbly here on the video, which is absolutely fine. As you can see, it still molds like cookie dough should, but it will be flaky because we haven't added our wet ingredients just yet. Okay, so I'm gonna add my one egg. This is a large egg. If you feel that your mixture is still too dry after mixing your one egg in, I wouldn't add any more eggs. Simply just add a couple of tablespoons of warm water, and that should do the trick just fine. Okay, making sure I mix it in well, and you should see a change in the consistency of the mixture. So it should go from sort of a dry cake base to a more doughy cookie mix. Okay. And I'm just going to test it with my hand again to see if the consistency is good for me. That looks pretty good to me. Okay, so now we are ready to put onto our baking tray. So for these, I actually put them in the oven for around 10 to 15 minutes. And just before I pop them in, I just put a little squeeze of honey in. And this is an optional extra in the recipe. You don't have to put this in. But I like my cookies a little bit gooey, so that's an optional extra if you like. But as I said, I pop these in for around 10 to 15 minutes at 150 Celsius. And you'll want to make sure that your cookies have space in between them. As you can see here, I've got a little bit of a gap. And that's just to make sure that when they start to expand, that they don't mold into each other. Okay. Here they are. So after our 15 minutes, we have nice, warm, gooey cookies. So these ones are soft on the inside, but they have a crunchy outer shell, which I absolutely love. I'm more of a gooey cookie fan than a sort of hard cookie or biscuit. So these are a definite win for me. But let me know what you guys think. And yeah, whether you'd like me to make some more baking videos for you, as I do enjoy making these, so I would absolutely love to. But I want to thank you all so much for watching. And I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Bye, guys.